Hey there, I'm Josh, and this week I'm going to be just joshing around doing
an unboxing
video.
I don't normally do the type of video where I unbox something and give my opinion on it, but I thought it'd be a nice change of pace. Plus, I was pretty flippin' excited to get this thing and show it and talk about it a bit. You see, this was my first major tool purchase for my shop, and my first ever brand new table saw. Up to this point, I've had two different table saws before this one. My first table saw was practically given to me, and it needed a lot of reconditioning. And even though I tinkered as much as I couldn't ever get it to cut perfectly straight. So I eventually replaced it with one that my father-in-law found at a yard sale for 10 bucks. And for the record, there was nothing wrong with it. It was just very light, and I couldn't do a lot of the cuts that I was wanting to perform. But it suited my purposes very well for the time that I had it. Since I first started dabbling in woodworking about 2 years ago, my skills and knowledge have very slowly but steadily increased. And with that comes not only the desire to perform more complex cuts, but an increase in accuracy and precision as well. So, after a healthy discussion with my financial planner, I decided it was time to bite the bullet and buy a brand new table saw. Now, I didn't want to just buy the first thing that popped up, but I also didn't want to blow a ginormous amount of money on one. So, after a lengthy bit of research, I decided to get this one. This is the Delta 36-5100 T2. No, not that T2. Although that might be a good inspiration for a nickname for this thing. Maybe I'll call it Arnie, which is of course short for Arnold Schwarzenegger. Anywho, yeah, after a bit of research, I decided to get this one. I didn't want to get something too small, and as I already mentioned, I didn't want to spend a ton of money on something like a saw stop or a grizzly, at least not yet. That may come down the road if I ever relocate to a larger shop space. But for now, what I have found with this saw is that it is the perfect blend of features and stability and portability. And yes, I'm speaking in the past tense because I've already had this thing for a couple weeks now, so I've used it quite a bit. And so far, I absolutely love it. One thing I need to mention is that this video is not meant to be in any way an expert review of this saw. And that's because I am not an expert. I'm just a dude who likes to play around with woodworking and painting toys. Having said that, I'll go ahead and give you my opinions on things so far. First of all, like you've already seen, this saw came in a giant box. And it was pretty heavy, 315 pounds to be exact. The folks over at Delta did a very good job with packing this thing for shipping. Because as I was unboxing it, I didn't notice any sort of damage at all. Everything was pristine, which is good. Second, the assembly instructions were excellent. The entire assembly process only took me a couple of hours, which honestly could have been quicker if I wasn't adjusting camera angles and such. The hardest part was ensuring that the tabletop was perfectly flush and level. One really cool feature is not only the storage of these safety devices, but how quick and easy it is to attach them into place. For both the blade guard and the anti-kickback pawls, the installation is super simple and requires no tools. Now, unlike the riving knife there, I honestly probably won't use these very much, but they're still nice features to have. Speaking of nice features, this fence is absolutely fantastic. And huge! This thing is seriously substantial. And the locking T-square design is nothing short of awesome, and it even has this little fold-down mini fence for smaller stock. Also, this miter gauge is pretty sweet as well. It has all of the common angles notched out and a little locking pin to ensure that you get the correct angle every time. One thing that I love about this saw is how sturdy and stable it is, even when you start the blade. And that's due to the heavy-duty cast iron tabletop and the two cast iron extension wings as well. A feature that I paid a bit extra for, but boy, am I glad I did. The dust collection on this saw works great as well, due to the port on the back of the saw which tracks with the blade position as well. Overall, I'm very pleased with my decision to purchase this saw, and I actually find myself getting very excited when different projects come up requiring the use of it, so that's a plus. One thing that I forgot to mention is that during my research before purchasing this saw, I found a decided lack of other people's reviews, and that's due to the fact that this thing actually just released a couple months ago. I did, however, find one guy's one-star review, which he rated that way because the saw doesn't have a 230-volt hookup. I'm not exactly sure why that's a negative review, though, because it's kind of like ordering a hamburger without cheese and then complaining that there's no cheese on it. You know what you're getting going into it, so I don't know. That's just my opinion. Anywho, my point is that while I usually use other people's reviews to kind of help me decide on something before purchase, this one required a little more blind faith, relying more on features than accolades, which kind of makes me nervous, but it's not super bad. So far, I have not been disappointed, and I am in fact quite satisfied with my purchase.
Hey there, thanks for watching. I know this video was a bit of a different flavor, and it technically wasn't really an unboxing video because I wasn't doing a live opinion as I went, but I just thought it'd be kind of cool to show you how this thing goes together and give you my initial review. Plus, I was just really excited about it. Anywho, thanks again for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please be sure to do all those normal things like liking and subscribing and sharing, ring that bell, you know, comment, maybe send it to the news, whatever you want to do. And keep an eye out because I might just have another custom collectible video coming very soon. But until then, take care of yourselves and I'll see you next time.